Ducks Bros. Haven't been showing the Ducks family too much love so far throughout this offseason, aside from a Trevor Zegras 1 year later video that we did a few months ago, but today we're talking about a few interesting trade ideas that were brought up by Eric Stevens on The Athletic. Now, I will say, Eric Stevens did publish this a few days ago, but it was recapped in a Spectre's Hockey article from August 2nd, 2020, which is where we're going to be pulling from today because The Athletic is paid for material, but regardless, the ideas still present itself as interesting discussion pieces, which is why we're bringing it up here today. What Stevens was talking about in his Anaheim Ducks-related article was five individual players that the Ducks could add from cap-crunched teams. I'll leave a link in the description to both this article and the Spectre's Hockey article that summarizes the Athletic article, so if you have the Athletic, you can go over, click on the link, and read this piece from Stevens, but because some of us don't have the Athletic, I'm just going to go from Spectre's Hockey so we can actually look at this because this is free and public available information. So today we're talking about two of the five individual players that are laid out in this article, but before we go over that, let's go over all the names first. These names that Eric Stevens put on a list as to who the Anaheim Ducks could target in the offseason include Chicago Blackhawks center Dylan Strome, Maple Leafs winger Kasperi Kapanen, Arizona Coyotes goalie Antti Raanta, St. Louis Blues winger Jaden Schwartz, and Vancouver Canucks winger Jake Virtanen. Now, okay, Virtanen is probably the one that most of the fans on this YouTube channel would look at and say, "Lego, talk about that one!" But I'm saving it. I'm uploading this video on Tuesday, August 4th. The Vancouver Canucks are playing the Minnesota Wild. I don't want to infiltrate the Vancouver Canucks media news cycle by uploading a news rumor video that day when we really should be focusing on the actual team probably losing against the Wild, maybe finding ways to improve and maybe squeaking out a win. I don't know, but today we're focusing on Dylan Strome and Antti Raanta, so let's go over just the facts about this and go over what exactly it is that Spectre's Hockey writes about these two players. Obviously, Stevens writes about all these players in his Athletic article, but we're going over the Spectre's Hockey one instead. Dylan Strome is a restricted free agent. He's a guy who was acquired by the Chicago Blackhawks a year ago in a trade from the Arizona Coyotes, and he's a guy who seemed to have found an offensive flair to his game that kind of disappeared during his time in the Desert State. Last season with the Arizona Coyotes, he had 6 points in 20 games played, he was then traded to Chicago, and he was under a point per game from that point on. This most previous season, however, saw Dylan Strome kind of fall off point production-wise, getting a significantly fewer amount of points, 38 points, in the same 58-game mark that he had with the Blackhawks. As a guy who was a pending RFA coming over for next season, and a guy who was noted as a potential trade candidate earlier in the summer, we had ourselves some discussion as to whether or not the Ducks would be a suitable team for Strome. Now, we all know the story of Strome. He's supposed to be a combination of a Trevor Zegras-like playmaking point producer and a Leon Draisaitl-like body. That was kind of the profile that Strome had heading into the 2015 NHL draft, where he was taken 3rd overall behind McDavid and behind Jack Eichel. Needless to say, if you know your stuff, the Arizona Coyotes didn't do a great job developing him. He didn't really showcase all that at the NHL level. The AHL saw some good seasons from Strome here and there, but going forward into the future, as a guy who is only 23 years old, there certainly is a lot more potential to untap. Even in the playoffs, in the play-in series against the Edmonton Oilers, at the moment of recording this video, he has 1 goal in 1 game played. And if you're an Anaheim team out there looking for a guy who could potentially be an immediate top 6 center, play him alongside the limited offensive talent that you have, guys like Jakob Silverberg, guys like Rickard Rakell, or if you want to add a little bit of size to a line, you could put a Nick Ritchie over there. There's a lot of options here if you want to build some future chemistry going forward with players who can impact the now while also influencing the future too. Strome to me is one of those guys who definitely does have a lot more to showcase at the NHL level, and even though he did have just under a point per game season with Chicago last season, that honestly seems like the brink of the iceberg compared to what we expected out of this guy a few years ago when he was drafted in 2015. So for the Anaheim Ducks, who do have a big boatload of draft picks coming up. They've got the Boston first this season. They've got their own first. They have extra picks in the 2022 draft with the Nashville Predators sixth. And with the selection of prospects that they do have as well, there's room to debate that a Dylan Strome trade from a Chicago Blackhawks team that's strapped for cap and that needs to re-sign so many RFAs that are on entry-level deals could be appropriate. It may be weird to see Dylan Strome suit up for a third team in the span of, like, what, 2 years or whatever, but at the same time, I've always been a believer in this guy, and I definitely want to see a development path into a star, because that's what we thought he could be, and since he's got a lot of time before he hits his prime, I honestly think there's a good enough chance to say that he could probably reach that than not. Furthermore, we have ourselves Antti Raanta, a different kind of situation here, but a different discussion entirely. He's also brought up in the Eric Stephens article, but if we go over to Spectre's Hockey, this is what they say about Raanta. He puts up solid numbers when healthy. The problem is, he's been banged up a lot in recent years. He'd make a good backup for John Gibson, but also carries a $4.25 million AAV for next year. That would make him a pricey understudy for Gibson. If the Coyotes move Raanta, it would be to shed some cap payroll to make room to re-sign Taylor Hall. They won't be keen to retain part of his salary. And that's what makes this whole discussion so interesting. The Anaheim Ducks have about $3 million in cap space, and the biggest guys that are expiring are Jacob Larsson, Michael Delzato, and Matt Irwin. Not to mention Ryan Miller, whom a lot of Ducks fans are saying could probably see another season in Anaheim, but it really just depends. Furthermore, a lot of this cap space is room that was freed up from the Kessler and Gudbranson deals that are currently on the LTIR. So for an Arizona team that was already trying to make offers to Taylor Hall with dinners done without the GM, with Gutierrez going out there trying to give him $7-point-something-million deals, starting out at that point and probably working their way up in contract negotiations, there probably is room for a Coyotes team to debate trading away an Antti Raanta. The numbers look pretty good. The guy had a 9.21 save percentage and a 2.63 goals against in 33 games played this past season. When he plays healthy, though, the guy can put upwards of a 9.30 save percentage. Now, Darcy Kuemper is a really good goalie, and we know that's kind of why Arizona has been so good over the past few stretches of time, but Antti Raanta's no joke either. And if you want to give yourself the opportunity to maybe get a few more games under your belt, Antti Raanta is a guy who could definitely help you win some of those. If you're worried about the cap, his contract expires in 2020-2021. So if the Anaheim Ducks wanted to go for a guy like this, hey, it would make a lot of sense in my opinion. Raanta to me is an upgrade over Ryan Miller and a very, very good player to play behind John Gibson. The entire Anaheim Ducks goaltending situation wasn't all too amazing because they both were under a 9.10 save percentage and over 3 goals against average. Sure, that comes in the territory when playing with a poor team, but a good goalie can help your team out tremendously. As for what could actually be given up, honestly, I don't know if there would be too much. Sure, Raanta's a very legitimate NHL-caliber goaltender, and sure, he's a guy whose contract could be seen as valuable enough to get a second or maybe two-thirds or something like that. It's just that the Coyotes are in a position of weakness where they need to free up money quickly, and they need to get Taylor Hall re-signed. They're going to try to do this. We know that Gutierrez and the owners and the CEO, they all want to get Taylor Hall back on their squad. With all the rumors that he's probably going to go to free agency, there's certainly going to be a lot of willpower to try to force the other hand here. And to me, freeing up space for a goaltender, when you already have a Darcy Kuemper who is very, very good in his own right as well, it opens the door to have a discussion about an Antti Raanta trade, which is what we're doing here in this video. So, talk to me in the comments below what you think about these two guys, Dylan Strome and Antti Raanta. How could they help out the Ducks? How could they make this team better? Furthermore, what do you think it would take to trade for these two players? And furthermore, would you like to see more videos done in this style? Eric Stephens has 3 more guys in his article, Jaden Schwartz, Jake Virtanen, and Kasperi Kapanen, that he discusses in this Anaheim Ducks article as well. So do you want to see videos made on those 3 guys as well? I'm certainly thinking about it because I haven't been given my Ducks Bros all too much love in this Ducks offseason, but of course, I'm open to suggestions, I'm open to reading all your comments and seeing what you have to say in the comments below. How do you think a Dylan Strome or a Raanta would help this team out? In my opinion, if you play Strome with the right guys, you could really grow some long-term chemistry for the future, and as for Antti Raanta, well, a good goaltender never makes a team worse, now doesn't he? But tell me what you think. Do you want to go for them? And what would it take? Let me know in the comments below. I hope you enjoyed this video. Search that Trollist99. And bye.